This is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. I have another exciting episode for you. Today, we're going to talk about pumpkins. So you can see behind me on my Kakai pumpkin trellis. And, it's held up fairly well. I mean, you know, a lot of people think you can't grow vertically. You know, you got to have, like, super reinforced trellises and whatnot to hold up pumpkins. And each one of these pumpkins may weigh up to 10 pounds. Maybe they're more around, like, 8. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Times 8. Like, that's like 72 pounds right here on this trellis, and we don't even have the trellis reinforced at the top, like over yonder. But nonetheless, it supports it. And last year, actually, I did build a monster trellis, which I think was actually a better use of a trellis than this wire mesh trellis. This wire mesh trellis was kind of like a pain to weave the pumpkins in and out of because of the small mesh. The larger monster trellis was a lot easier to weave the pumpkins in and out of. And this mesh actually would be a lot better for the cucumbers, where we grew the cucumbers this year on the monster trellis, and the spacing on that was not optimal for the cucumbers. In any case, today's the day of the pumpkin harvest. Now, how do I know today's the day for the pumpkin harvest? Well, it's because I finally got around to it. The other reason why I know it's today is because basically all the vines have dried up and the plants are no longer growing. So if we kept them on the vine anymore, they may just rot, or they're just gonna hang out and be preserved. So today we're gonna go ahead and collect all the pumpkins. We planted them about maybe one plant every 1 foot in this raised bed, and we're gonna weigh up and give you guys a total yield on how much 15 plants in one raised bed interplanted with things like cauliflower and celery and parsley could actually yield. Before I get into the harvesting, I actually want to show you guys why I grow this pumpkin. Here's one right here that was harvested a little while ago. It actually fell off the vine. And this is a nice little cute pumpkin. Now, you could use this pumpkin for like a jack-o'-lantern, but that would be an incredible waste of a really good pumpkin. The reason why I like the Kakai pumpkin so much is because of the seeds. The seeds, unlike your standard Halloween pumpkin that are white, these are actually green in color, and they're hullous. So let's go ahead and cut open this pumpkin and check out what it looks like on the inside. All right, so we're just gonna cut this open like a jack-o'-lantern so I can stick my hand in on the inside and pull out all the delicious seeds. All right, there we go. So check it out. You can see inside, this is the standard pumpkin flesh. Now, a question I get a lot is, hey, John, how's that pumpkin flesh tasting? You know, does it taste like a butternut squash? What does it taste like? Well, you know, the taste of this pumpkin is nondescript. It's kind of like a standard, you know, Halloween pumpkin. It's not necessarily sweet, but it is absolutely edible. So you definitely would probably want to cook this up. I rarely eat this raw. Actually, let me go ahead and try that for you guys right now. We're going to go ahead and cut this section off and see what this stuff tastes like raw. And this has a nice, dark, rich orange color. Now, I want to encourage you to eat your foods of color. Every different color of the rainbow has different antioxidants. This, because it is kind of orange, probably has some beta carotene in there. Wow, you know, it tastes pretty much like a standard jack-o'-lantern pumpkin. Actually, a little bit sweeter. I wouldn't say it's anywhere near butternut, but it's definitely good. This would probably be really good shredded up on top of a salad. Besides the flesh, the reason why I grow these specifically, once again, are for the seeds. So let's take a look inside this pumpkin and check it out. All right, so there's inside. This little section I cut off there to eat it. And look at this inside. I mean, this pumpkin is really filled with these little seeds. And these are, once again, the hullus seeds. And these are the reason why I grow the hullus pumpkin for the green seeds that you can just literally take out. Oh man, eat fresh. What does that taste like? These fresh pumpkin seeds are so water rich. Because they're so water rich, they have actually a lower fat percentage because of the water takes up some of it. Man, they're just so good. I can't describe the flavor. The reason why I'm growing the Kakai pumpkins to get the little seeds, or the pepitas, which are often called Mexican pumpkin seeds that you could find at your local health food store, is because I want to be able to grow some sort of fat. It'd be kind of unrealistic to grow a nut tree and have it produce in one season, whereas I could grow easily 15, pumpkin vines and grow these seeds. I mean, I guess another one I could also grow would be sunflower seeds, but then that'd be a real pain to deshell all the sunflower seeds unless I had some kind of mechanical huller. So these are really simple to grow and will provide me a source of fats in the winter time. And each one is definitely loaded up with seeds in there. I mean, all these seeds are just all the way, you know, mixed in here. So many. Once you open the pumpkin, you should use these seeds within actually a day or two. Otherwise, they're gonna obviously go moldy and bad. But what I choose to do to preserve the seeds is dehydrate them. Man, the fresh ones are just so good. I think I'll eat some of these tonight for dinner. So what I'll do is I'll take out the seeds, put them in the dehydrator, actually with all this pithy stuff and all, and just dehydrate all this. And then when they're done, usually I'll just take out the whole bunch and just eat it. And actually the white pithy stuff and the seeds together taste super primo. Here are some seeds from a smaller Kakai pumpkin that wasn't quite as mature that were ready and dehydrated. And now these are ready for storage. And you could go to your local health food store and buy these seeds. Now, if you do that, the seeds from the health food store, from what I've heard, are not viable, meaning they have been heat processed so that you can no longer buy those seeds and plant them and grow them. They're just gonna literally rot. So you do need to get these from a verified seed source where they have been processed properly if you wanna grow the kakais. So we're gonna go ahead and take this handful of seeds. Nice, crunchy, delicious. Pumpkin seeds are an incredible food. They're high in L-tryptophan, which some people say can be good to help people with anxiety and things like that. In addition, it's actually very high in iron. So if you need extra iron, eat and grow some pumpkin seeds. In addition, some cultures actually use the pumpkin seeds to basically deworm you or for parasites. And it makes good reason, because if the pumpkins were growing on the ground and there is worms in there, the pumpkins don't want the worms to eat it, so there's properties in the pumpkins that naturally repel them. In any case, now is the time I get to harvest the rest of the kakais. We're gonna go ahead and stand up here and just start picking these guys off. The other thing that'll happen when these guys are ready to be harvested, they'll actually just break off the vine fairly easy. The vine actually gets nice and brittle. Now, another reason why I wait till the absolute end to harvest these, because you could harvest these actually at any age, I want the most mature seeds on the inside. If I wasn't growing these for seed, if I was growing them for the meat, maybe I'd harvest them younger when they're more tender. But I want the seeds, so I want the seeds to get a chance to fully develop. Anyways, there's one. Here's another one. These things are just so pretty. All right, there's another one. Moving down the line. There's a big one. Continuing to harvest. So you can see I literally harvested a whole bunch of the Kakai pumpkins. Now once again, this was literally off 15 square feet, one plant per foot. And once again, they are grown vertically to get them off the ground to maximize the use of my space. I definitely think for 15 square feet, this was actually quite a hefty yield, and actually still have some inside. So next we're gonna take these inside one by one, weigh them up, and we're gonna let you know the total poundage. I just got done weighing all the pumpkins, and you can see I have most of them stacked on the shelf behind me. Now, overall, I had 41 pumpkins total for a total of 216.16 pounds. So 216 pounds is an incredible amount of poundage for just 15 square feet of growing space. That equated about 14.41 pounds per square foot when growing the Kakai pumpkins. I think that growing the Kakai pumpkins was definitely an excellent use of the available, once again, vertical space to grow vertically so that I can have a lot of the hullus pumpkin seeds for eating this winter. Now, another question you may be asking, John, you know, how do you know what pumpkins to use first? Well, in general, what happens is the green pumpkins should be used first. They're the most immature, and because they have the softest shell, they may actually go bad, you know, quickly. So actually, the other indicator is you could take your finger and press on the shell, and if it gives a little bit like an avocado when it's ripe, you've got to be using it like ASAP. Another indicator that you may want to do is locate any kind of discoloration, bad marks, or anything like that, and use obviously those first. I had one or two that had a little bit of bug damage that I'll also be using first. Some of the ones that are more hard and firm, these pumpkins will last. Actually, last year I had one stored that lasted about 7 months. So on average, maybe 6 to 7 months for the nice, firm, hard ones. Of course, if you get ones that are not fully mature and soft, they're not gonna last that long. So instead of just opening all these, using all the seeds to dehydrate, to have a whole massive amount of seeds at once, and then have a lot of pumpkin meat to eat, you know, I'm gonna basically go through these through the winter, you know, one at a time, eat out or dehydrate the seeds, and then also we'll be able to use the meat of the pumpkin. Once again, this pumpkin is not a sweet pumpkin. It tastes more like a standard Halloween pumpkin. Good nonetheless. You could cook them up, grill them up, steam them, saute them, shred them into salads, just as you would use a regular pumpkin. So hopefully you've enjoyed this episode learning more about the Kakai pumpkins and my yield for this year. I was definitely impressed, and hopefully you were too, and maybe next year you'll even grow the Kakai hullus pumpkins and like them as much as I do. Once again, my name is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. We'll see you next time, and remember, keep on growing.